today we'll solve that lesson exercise. But before starting the lesson, we'll say one vachana today. Okay. Tande neenu, taayi neenu, bandhu neenu, balaga neenu, neenillade mattaru illavayya, koodala sangama deva. So this is the one vachana of Basavanna. Okay. Shall we start the exercise? All of you open page number 22. Open page number 22. Sorry, it's page number 21. Not 22, 21. Exercise. Talk exercise. Let us understand who said these to whom. What has been done for you? Here they have given some lines. Some two sentence, two lines they have given. By reading that, you need to recognize who said this to whom. Well, at last you are here. You never greeted me, but now you have come around with your digging stick. Go away and leave me alone. Who said this? The I said these words to a countryman who was a farmer. The yam said these words to the countryman who was a farmer. Yes. So like that some questions they have given. You need to answer that. Second one. Man put me down softly. Man put me down softly. Who said this? To whom? The answer is the palm tree branch. I will write the answer here. The palm tree branch said these words to the farmer. Okay. Next. Is that third one? Third question. Is that all? Is that so frightening? Who said this to whom? The fisherman said these words to the farmer. The fisherman said these words to the farmer. Next, all of you copy in your textbook with the pencil. Next, fourth one, where are you going in such a rush? The weaver said these words. The weaver said these words. The weaver said these words to the farmer and the fisherman. To the farmer and the fisherman. To both the persons, the weaver told this. Farmer and the fisherman. ಹೌದಲ್ಲ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಫಿಶರ್ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಓಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಆವಾಗ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಡು ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಮೀಟ್ ಆದ್ರು ವೇವರ್ ಭೇಟಿ ಆಗ್ತಾನೆ. ವೇವರ್ ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗಿ ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು, ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ರಶ್, ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಯಾಕೆ ನೀವು ಅರ್ಜೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತಂದು ಆ ವೇವರ್ ಅವರಿಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಒನ್, ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಅ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಲಿ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ದ ಚೀಫ್ of the village said these words to the farmer, fisherman and the weaver. The village chief said these words to the farmer, fisherman and the weaver. Is this clear? Okay. Next, There is a sixth one, last one. Fantastic, isn't it? Imagine a talking am. Who said this to whom? This is one homework. You find out in the lesson and write the answer. I won't tell this answer. I have told you the five answers. The sixth one is left to you. Okay. Next, answer the following questions. Why did the farmer become frightened and why did he run? Why the farmer became frightened? Because the everything was talking when the farmer went to dig the ground. So that time the yam said that now you came to dig me here, go away. Isn't it? Next, the dog came and listened the what the yam said carefully. Next, when the farmer went to near the palm tree, he took the branch. The palm tree said, keep my branch down. Isn't it? So when he went to keep that branch down, the stone talked, don't keep it on me, take off. Isn't it? The everything was talked. So the farmer was got frightened. So the answer is lengthy, so I cannot write the answer in the board here. I will send these question answers to your WhatsApp. Okay. We'll move next. Herds. What change could animals and plants bring about in the world if they could talk? So this is your activity. What change could animals and plants bring about in the world if they could talk? Imagine if the animals and the plants were talking, what the changes they could have bring to the world? That you need to list out. Now turn the page number 22, vocabulary. Fill the blanks with the choosing correct words given in the help box. In the help box, they have given the five words. By choosing that, you need to fill that blanks. The first one is, it is a common to wish someone when you meet them. Here the answer is courtesy. It is common courtesy to wish someone when you meet them. Okay. Next, second, the zoo authorities have barred the entry to the aquarium these days as some repairs are going on. Okay. I will write the answers here. You copy these answers. Shall I rub this? The first answer is courtesy. Vocabulary I am telling. Courtesy. Next, the second answer is barred. Third answer is I love the fragrance of roses. So write fragrance. Fourth one, when all the bulbs were lit, the chandelier. The chandelier looked magnificent. Okay, next, fifth one, he brought an expensive gift for his friend. Expensive. The fifth one is expensive. Okay. Next, listening and speaking. Make a groups of two. Discuss with your partner and list five places that are silent and five places that are noisy. For example, a library is a silent place, but a market is a noisy. Yes. So you need to make a five places things. So noisy places and silent places. Okay. Example, they have given that library. Library hang irutte, full silent irutte. Mat adhi tara yava silent irutte. For example, temple. Temple is also so silent. Yes, like that. Make a list of five things. Next, noisy places. For example, market, bus stand, railway station. These are all the noisy places. So make five list of the noise place. Okay. Next, come coming to the language and grammar, rewrite the sentences using the correct words which give a feeling of a fright and horror. Here they have highlighted the some words that fright and horror. An adjective is a word that describes the noun. Here the adjective which describes the noun, we call it as the adjective. For example, happy, sad, horror, frightened. These are all the adjectives of a noun. First one, the farmer began to run. How the farmer began to run? They have given two options here, frightened or a old. Which one you will choose? The farmer was an old man? No. So you should choose frightened. The first one is underline the frightened. Frightened. So by choosing this word, you need to rewrite the sentence by using this word frightened. That is, the frightened farmer began to run. Okay, next, second one. A loud or a blood curdling scream was suddenly heard in the darkness. Here, blood curdling. Second one is blood curdling. So choose this one. Use this word and make that sentence. Next, third one. He saw a short or a weird thing near the water. So not a short thing, it is weird thing. He saw the weird thing. So use this word and make that sentence. Weird thing near the water. Next, fourth one. He was too warm or terrified to move. Fourth one is terrified. Next, fifth one. Cold feelings or shivers or water ran down his spine. Cold shivers. So fifth one, shivers. He could see two bigger glaring or round eyes looking at him. He could see two glaring eyes looking at him, glaring. These are all the adjective of a noun. Seventh one, he was alarmed or ashamed and began to run once more. Alarmed. A-L-A-R-M-E-D. So choose this one. Okay. Next. So clear? Next, turn the page. Page number 23. Look at these sentences. Here they have given some sentences. I went to school. He has gone to school. When he arrived in school, he found that the teacher had left. Here, do you know tenses? Past tense, present tense and future tenses. So here they have given the three sentences. Went. Which one it is? Which tense it is? Went is a past tense. He has gone. He has gone means past participle. He has gone. This is the past participle. Next, when he arrived in a school, he found that the teacher had left. The teacher has already left. Okay, like that here, they have given some words. By using that, you need to fill that blanks. I will tell you the answers. Okay, so open page number 23. Yes, Rohan dashed home a long time. No one has dashed him since lunchtime. So, Rohan went home a long time ago. So, the first blank you need to fill with the went. The Rohan went home a long time ago. No one has seen him. So here seen. See, saw, seen. See, saw, seen. See andre present tense, saw andre past tense. Seen andre past participle. Okay. Next. Riya had gone to her friend's house. Gone. So, write this one. Next. Riya had gone to her friend's house to see her friend. To see her friend. Here you need to write see. Present. But she was not there. Meera has gone to the shop. Next, third answer is again gone. Don't confuse. Second one is also gone. Third one is also gone. Meera has gone to the shop to buy eggs. She saw her old friend on the way to the shop. Saw. Okay, next. Have you seen my ball? Whenever you are asking to the question, your opposite person, that time you need to ask, have you seen my ball or have you seen my pen? So, have you seen? My friends have gone to play football and I want to join them. So, in the next blank, you need to write gone. My friends have gone. Already hogibittidare, gone. Hogu annodakke go, hogtiddare, going, hogiddare, gone. Okay. Next. Fifth one. The film went on and it was so boring that we all got up and went home halfway. So here two blanks you fill with the went only. Went. Sixth one. I have seen that girl somewhere before. I have seen that girl somewhere before. Next. I think I saw her at the exhibition. The first blank is seen. Second one is saw. Next. Seventh one. I went to see my grandmother. So, in the next, you need to write went. I went to see my grandmother. First one is went. Second one is see. Okay, I went to see my grandmother. But she had gone out. She had gone out. Next blank is gone. Nana, nam grandmother nodak hogidde. Hogidde anodendu went. ಅವಾಗ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿ ಮೈ ನಾನು ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ನನ್ನ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮದರಿಗೆ ನೋಡಕ್ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ನೋಡು ಸಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ನೋಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ಬಟ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾನ್ ಔಟ್ ಅವ್ರು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ರು ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗಾನ್ ಅವ್ರು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ರು ಗಾಟ್ ಮೈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಸಾ ಸೀನ್ ಗೋ ಗಾನ್ ಗಾನ್ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ C1, Leela shouted for help. So, you need to use the which direct speech and indirect speech. So, it is in the C. Rewrite the following sentences by changing them into the indirect speech without changing the meaning. Direct speech refers to the exact words of the speaker. Directly maatadodu. Speaker jothege edirigiravaru jothe direct maatadodu. That is the direct speech. Indirect agi andre indirect speech andre aa person irodilla alli. So indirect agi adike enantivu naavu indirect speech. For example, go away and leave me alone, said the am to the farmer. Illond example kottara farmer matte am ibbara nadve conversation aadaga aa am yarige aa farmer ge en helthu go away leave me alone direct agi helthala alle farmer ittu am idru ಆಮ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಇಬ್ರು ಇದ್ರು ಸೊ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತದ್ದು ಇದು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ Next, indirect speech andre gives only the substance of what the speaker said and not the exact words he or she used. Exact words irudilla indirect speech avu heng helu hange irudilla avu hing helidare anta heltivi navu but exact irudilla words alli en irudilla particular agi exact irudilla so that is called as the indirect speech. For example, the ant told the farmer to go away and leave it alone. Illi am heltu anta na heltivi yalli indirect speech alli okay but direct speech alli avrore maatadtaralli इंडैरेक्ट अल्ली ओ अद हिंग हेळितंत अद हिंग हेळितंत आम फार्मर हिंग हेळितंत अंत इंडैरेक्टली ना हेळ्तीवी दैट इज इंडैरेक्ट स्पीच सो लीला शाउटेड हेल्प हेल्प द फर्स्ट वन इज लीला शाउटेड हेल्प हेल्प सो लीला शाउटेड फॉर हेल्प हियर दे हैव गिवन द डायरेक्ट स्पीच लीला शाउटेड हेल्प हेल्प प्रेजेंट आगे लीला ऐन मार्तिदाळे शाउट मार्तिदाळे हेल्प हेल्प अंतंद अदन्न नीवु ऐन माडबेकु लीला शाउटेड फॉर हेल्प लीला पापा चीर्ता इद्लंते हेल्प माड्री अंतंद अंत इनडायरेक्ट आगि हेळोदु डायरेक्ट इद्दिदन्न इनडायरेक्ट आगि कन्वर्ट माडबेकु इनडायरेक्ट इद्दिदन्न डायरेक्ट आगि कन्वर्ट माडबेकु नेक्स्ट सेकंड वन द टीचर सेड यू मस्ट डू युवर होमवर्क नीटली द टीचर सेड यू मस्ट डू युवर होमवर्क नीटली द टीचर सेड दैट ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಟೀಚರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಇನ್ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋದಂದ್ರೆ ದ ಟೀಚರ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೀಚರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಂತೆ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಂತೆ ಡೂ ಯುವರ್ ಹೋಮ್ವರ್ಕ್ ನೀಟ್ಲಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಮೈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಓಕೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ 3 ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಟ್ರೈ ಇಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹೋಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಯು ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಯುವರ್ WhatsApp ನಂಬರ್ ಓಕೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು